All right, folks, 161 is on the table. There it is. Welcome to, what is it, Wednesday? I guess it would be hump night breaks with Bad Yorkie card breaks. Yeah, sounds kind of weird. Anyway, hey, 161 up this morning and down this afternoon. That's fantastic. I threw up a little group poll there in the chat. Let me know what you think. Yeah, I think there's a lot of potential there with that SP game using SPX break. And it's for what it is, for a 20 boxer. I mean, let's run the math on that right now. 31 teams in the NHL. That's 60 cards for game used and 40 cards for SPX coming out of that break. That's 100 cards. You're bound to hit something. And every one of those cards is going to be take away one or two cards in the SP game used, in each SP game used box. Every one of those is a pretty significant hit. So I don't know. I kind of like the idea of throwing up game used in an SPX. You guys let me know what you think, but we're not bluffing. Here they are. Just went and pulled those right off the shelf. You tell me that's what you want, and we'll throw up. We can throw them up. Sean Ekman, he did start the trilogy party in this group. That's a heavy. This is gonna be a fun break. It's gonna be a marathon break. 20 boxes. That heavy. I'll do it. I'm off on Friday too. Well, I'm off tomorrow as well. I'm working teleworking, but I'm definitely taking Friday completely off. So we get some momentum moving into the weekends. I got a huge, huge shipment coming from our New York distributor that arrives tomorrow afternoon. It's our second locked-in regular. I think we're on like a recurring 2 to 3 shipments from them right now a week. It's a huge shipment. So we got some great stuff coming up for this weekend. It's going to be a fun weekend. But hey, yeah, Steve will say. I think Steve is dying to get back in the hunt from what I've heard. He wants back in the hunt, but he's got to take care of get his I think he said he's got to get a couple more cards sold or get his collection a little more under control. But the good news is he finally did pick up a draft day Mark Zadina. I think he bought it on eBay. Unfortunately, we couldn't help him out by pulling him one yet. But there's a darn good chance we'll pull it out of a 20 boxer if we post that bad boy. Give me a thumbs up. You can hear me loud and clear. I'm assuming you all can. And then I'll get this roster read. We'll get cranking on 161. Order of March tonight is going to be, it's going to be our regular order of March, which is going to be Trilogy first, then Game Used, then X, and then Black Diamond. So that's going to be your order of pull right there. And all the Trilogy hits will ship. And then... obviously, all the other cards from the other 6 boxes, which are all hits, those are going to you no matter what. So give me a thumbs up. We'll get going. I am ready for Premier to come out. I'm sure he needs the rest. I just didn't. I think he got an I. I don't think it was a Z. I think it was an I. I think he got an I. But yeah, let's get going. I'm ready for Premier. I'm ready for the Cup. I posted that poll up earlier today, buybacks, folks. How about that? I was looking at that product and the offering this year and how much stuff is in there to include a ton, not a ton, but, I think there's like in total, like 45 different possible young gun variants from McDavid's rookie year you could pull out, including an autographed acetate. Buybacks are good to go. And I'm going to get them moving to Alaska. I think that poll I did earlier today kind of sealed the deal. So buybacks, get ready for it. It's a little spendier. Obviously, nothing like it's more along the lines of what Premier is. Nothing like what the Cup is going to be, I'm sure. But yeah, it's going to be good. Oh, so maybe he's got two then. Okay, we'll see. I'm sure he'll be back with us shortly, chasing something else from the Red Wings. All right, here we go. The roster tonight for this break 161. Anaheim Ducks is Ray Rangel. Coyotes, Mini. Boston Bruins, Kyle Hoglander. Sabres, Tommy Holmesberger. Flames, Aaron Ford. Hurricanes, Sean Heckman. Blackhawks, Keaton Parker. Avalanche, Ray Rangel. Blue Jackets go to the Mini. Saracino has the Stars. Aaron Ford's got the Red Wings. Nathan DeGagne has the Oilers. Panthers go to the Mini. CPB's got the Kings. Keaton Parker's got the Wild. Joshua Parker's got Canadians. Sean Heckman's got the Preds. We don't have the Preds, so Sean Heckman has them. It's okay. It's all right. Philip Nascimento, New Jersey Devils. Kyle Hoglander, the Islanders. CPB's got the Rognes. Curtis Robinson's got the Sens. Sean Heckman has the Flyers. CPB's got the Penguins. Sharks go to the Mini. Blues go to Jennifer Lewis. Lightning go to the Mini. Leafs go to Nick Cirino. Canucks go to the Mini, which is fantastic. So much value in that Mini tonight. VGK goes to Larry Resch. Sean Heckman's got the Caps, and Tommy Holmesberger takes the Jets. In the Mini tonight, we've got the Coyotes, the Blue Jackets, the Panthers, the Sharks, the Lightning, and the Vancouver Canucks. Digit 1, Kyle Hoglander. Digit 2, Ray Rangel. Digit 3, Nick Cirino. 4, 5, and 6 go to Sean Heckman. Brandon Leston has 7. Joshua Parker has 8. Keaton Parker has 9. Larry Resch has 0. And Sarah Rossino pulls the all-important wildcard slot, which you know is going to have cards because we're cracking Trilogy tonight. And that's a great place to be right now. All right, give me 20 seconds, and then we're going live with our first box of Trilogy. You say you pulled a McDavid 14-15 Cup Auto Dual Patch the other day from Mini for Edmonton. McDavid's rookie year was 15-16. Is that how'd you pull a 14-15 Cup Auto? I'm just curious. Unless it was an Erie Otters patch. But that, I mean, that's a heck of a card. That's sick. I would love to see it. That's awesome. 14-15 Cup Auto Dual Patch the other day. Mini for Edmonton. $29. I'm sure it sounds like it might have been 15 or 16 or maybe 16-17. Either way, that's outstanding. Oh, 14 out of 15. I got you. Okay. Oh, 14 out of 15, the number on the card. Wow, okay. I get it. I'm sorry. I thought you were saying 14 or 15 the year. I was like, no, I have seen actually some throwback cards from that vintage. There's actually one out there. I think that is super, super up there. It's got McDavid and Erie Otters. Playing for them, the OHL, and then it's got Crosby on it with a Penguins jersey. It's kind of a weird, unique card. Man, love to have some of that stuff. That is awesome. Yeah, you decide you want to move that McDavid 14 out of 15 Cup Auto Dual Patch. You let me know. We are always on the hunt for McDavid's. Yeah, good luck, everybody. Let's get going. Who's ready? Give me a thumbs up. You can hear me loud and clear as I take a sip of this golden drink next to me, and then we're going to get started. I think we're 17-18 the cup. Okay, there we go. Now that makes sense. That makes sense. Sorry, I wasn't questioning you. I just wanted to, when you start talking about the McDavid stuff, I kind of keep a mental track of where everything's at as far as his super premier cards and what we should possibly, you know, if some of these cards I've never seen before. And I see people post these cards, like I'm hoping Kyle sends me a picture of that card because I'd love to see it. And as we see these cards, it kind of helps me decide what we're going to move towards doing here later in the summer for you guys. If we want to do some throwback breaks like we've already done, sounds like 17-18 cup would be pretty sick. All right, here we go. Trilogy, first pack. Open it up right now. See what we got. Mark Scheifele base for the Jets. Ryan Poehling, rookie renditions. And then a big old decoy. Here's a Ryan Kupner for the Red Wings. Aaron Ford picks that one up. It's a limited. Looks like a little blue action. I think it's 200 of 399. We'll get that wrapped up and sent out to you. Base Mountain is going to start right next to us. Next up, second pack, first box of Trilogy. Here we go. Jonathan Drouin. And then behind it, a Victor Olofsson. Trilogy rookie renditions for the Sabres. And we will move that to Tommy Holmesberger. And then behind it, Golden Knights, Cody Glass, 198-ish. No, 196 for Larry Resch. Little Ruby, Trilogy rookie renditions for Cody Glass. There you go. Matt Barzell. Immediately following this break, I will wrap all these kind of mid-hits for Trilogy up for you all as we normally package them. It takes forever, so I don't want to slow this break down, keep this momentum going. That way we're out of here by midnight. Midnight for us. Riley Stillman, rookie rendition for the Panthers. That's going to go to the mini, so we'll push that to Sarah Racino. And then right behind it, Arizona Coyotes. A Barrett Hayton Trilogy Rookie Premier Level 1 jersey card. And it's $465. That's a Sean Heckman pickup because the Coyotes go to the mini. $465 out of $499. And a Clayton Keller base right behind it. Grab some Crow. Pick up some protection here. Table stocked. Regulars. Some 5-pointers. Hundos. And the all-important 180s that you know are yet to come out of the later boxes. And potentially out of here, too. Sean Heckman picked up a giant card. Giant card about a week ago. Out of Trilogy. It was a monster. It was almost pushing the limit on a 180 top loader. So, let's see what we got here. Very nice. Barrett Hayton. Jersey card. Get that decoy ready for later on. Get some stands lined up to take a look at these hits as we pull them. Throw Barrett Hayton right there on the corner and get going with pack number 4. What do we got going on here? Yeah. Seems like a abnormally thick pack, but who knows? With Trilogy, could be anything. Let's see if I can even get it open. Sure, I can get it open. There we go. All right. Let's see what we got here. What could we have? Dylan Larkin. Behind it, Rudolph Bouchers for the Sens. Senators. Very nice. Send that to Curtis Robinson. And right behind it, oh goodness, how about that? Goalie for the Kings, Martin Jones. Cody Phillip Blom. That is a beaut. Signature puck. Trilogy signature puck right there with the Taylor Hall base behind it. Look at that. CPB. There you go, buddy. Martin Jones. Goalie puck. Gold pen signed. Beautiful. Cody Phillip Blom. Outstanding. That and a nice little beauty of a top loader right there. Outstanding. Look at that. We're on the board with mega cards now. All right, next up. Got in pack number 5 of this box. Pastrnak base, Oliver Wahlstrom for the Islanders. We'll push that to Kyle Hoglander. Behind it, we've got a Carl Grundstrom. There's another Kings hit for Cody Phillip Blom. 347 on 599. It's a level 1. Level 1. There's some sort of gymnastics competition going on upstairs in my house right now. If it's Hayden or Jenny doing the tumbling, but oh well, we're gonna keep going just in case. Here we go, last pack of the first box of Trilogy. Patrick Kane base, followed up by Trent Frederick for the Bruins. We'll push that to Kyle Hoglander, and then behind it, Ilya Mikheyev for the Leafs. Nick Cirino, that's a level 2, 485 out of 499. Beautiful card right there, and Jack Eichel base behind it. All right. Get this into a 75-pointer. And then we're going to move on to Trilogy box number 2. Keep a little bit of a rhythm going tonight. All right. Not bad. Barrett Hayton, level 1. Mikheyev, level 2. Grundstrom, level 1. And then a big old signature puck for Martin Jones going to Cody Phillip Blom. And then a bunch of rookie renditions that we will package up later and push out to the teams. All right. Base Mountain, not too bad yet. All right. 5/5 McDavid Trilogy Patch Auto. That's pretty sick, Josh Parker. Love to see that as well. That's awesome. I'd love to see a real high definition picture of it and then a price tag of what you're looking to get out of it attached to it. Most of that stuff people are going to end up sitting on for a while, but I always ask, I'm just curious. All right, Trilogy box number 2, here it comes. Let's see what we got here. Here's the packs in the empty box. Here we go. Pack number 1. Elias Pettersson, base card, followed up by Nathan Bastian for the Devils, Philip Nascimento. Oh, baby. Oh, my goodness. This is what happens when we don't take the Preds. Look at this. Sean Heckman. You got a Fibro Level 1 auto. That is a beautiful card right there. And it is numbered, kind of hard to see with all the hologram action going on. 368 out of 399 for the Predators. Beautiful card. I love that card. That is a good-looking card. Goodness. Outstanding. Fibro Trilogy Rookie Premieres. Little sticker auto, level 1. Okay, well, that's a good start to this box. Fibro. All right. Well done, Sean Heckman. Very nice. I'll check out your picture as soon as we're done here. Joshua Parker just got it. Looks like it just came in, but unfortunately, I can't look at it until we're done with the break. But I'll check it out as soon as we're done. Look forward to seeing it. Another McKeviv for there. And oh my goodness, what is going on here? Oh, man, RV2? Man, and a McDavid base behind it. Outstanding trilogy for the Preds so far. Another Sean Heckman pickup. He's got the Preds. He's got the hits coming out of this box. This is a very good, this otherwise would be a very good box for us. As it had a Fibro Auto RV Red jersey card. And then a nice little McDavid base in it as well behind it. Hot box. Oh my. Don't tell Hayden. He'll sniff this out. There's no way I can get that from him. He's going to come down here. We got 8 boxes open. He's going to find his way down here and take a look and then freak out. Patrick Kane, and then we'll get yelled at for not taking the Preds in this break. Patrick Kane base behind it. Ryan Lindgren. There's a Cody Phil Blom pickup for the Rangers. And behind, oh, there's another. Holy smokes. Hey, look at that. Little what do they call that? When they inscription action going on for the Bruins. Who's got the Bruins? Kyle Hoglander. Zach Senyshyn inscription level 3. 24/49. Even wrote Go Bruins on there. That's a cool card. That's cool right there. Man, that's a good looking card. Trilogy is growing on me more and more every single time. I gotta get this wrapped up. This is a beauty of a card for Zach Senyshyn. Look at that. He wrote Go Bruins on it. I think that's gonna be considered a level 3 inscription card. Very rare. Beautiful and rare. That's going to Kyle Hoglander. Picking up the Bruins in this break. Well done. Look at that beauty. Go Bruins. Zach Senyshyn. I knew it. Knew this was going to be a good break. So glad we closed it today. This is awesome. Kyle Hoglander. There you go. Yeah, Preds are still available in 126. We'll see. A little disappointed in myself right now. No, it's okay. It's good. We let our teams go. I mean, everybody used to think there for a couple breaks we were jumping all over the Oilers, but literally when we ran the math, I think out of the 50 or so breaks we've done so far, we've had the Oilers in like 4 of them. So the Preds are about the same. I think we pick the Preds a little more often because if I'm going to push the Preds are going to go to the mini, I'm going to pick them up just to kind of help you guys keep that mini dollar amount down low and get it closed faster. The Oilers will never go to the mini, obviously. Shifley, there's another Zach Senyshyn for Kyle. And behind it, we've got a Mackenzie McCarron for the Blues, Jennifer Lewis. That's pretty cool. 508 to 799 Ruby edition, Taylor Hall base behind it. Get this wrapped up for you. Beauty.
Beautiful. Heart protection all over the place. I'm gonna keep up with you guys. There we go. Let's get that posted. Try to get these on some sort of a line here. I keep bumping them because we got so many boxes on the table. We got a break tonight. This is great. Can't wait to see what this table looks like with that 20 boxer I'm about to post at 9 a.m. tomorrow morning for you guys. Blue Jackets, rookie rendition, Texier, that goes to the mini. That's going to go to Sarah Rossino. No serial number. My goodness, what is this, the auto box? Is it, I mean, how many autos are you supposed to get in a box of Trilogy? Somebody key me into this, because this is three. This is the third one. We got a Fabro, Senishin, and now we got a Blake Lizotte going to Cody Phil-Blom for the LA Kings. Another, that's a level one. Behind it, a Noah Dobson for the Islanders. Kyle Hoglander takes another one, and behind it, a Carter Hart base. Holy smokes. Is this normal? Or is this a little bit of a tuned-up box we got going on here? That's the third Trilogy Rookie Premier auto we've pulled out of this box. I don't think that's normal. I've only opened a few boxes of this year. But as far as I know, that's not normal. A little bit of a hot box. What does the box say? Should say it? What would the box say on it? The Trilogy box. Would it say something on it if it was a hot box? There'd be a way for us to tell? I don't think so. Anyway, we still got one pack left. It's a heater. It's a heater of a box, yeah. Cody Phil-Blom. I'm talking about 20 boxer. So I'm trying to get back in the rhythm of keeping one big break and one small break open, two at a time, just like when we started. But I think we got the membership to support closing out at least one of them a day, if not more, for you guys. I want to post tomorrow morning a 20 boxer, 10 boxes of game used and 10 boxes SBX from 1920. You tell me what you guys think. Well, how many? Oh, yeah. I mean, you should say how many autos. We've opened a few boxes of Trilogy in the past week, and we have never pulled three autos out of five packs. So I think this box is tuned up just a little bit. Somebody else can run the odds, but unfortunately I don't have, I'd love to take a look right now. I guess it would say on the pack, but I'm almost positive that the odds are not that you get three autos to include an inscription auto per box. This has got to be somewhat of a tuned up box. Druin, Braden Point, Abramov. And then how about a Quinn Hughes? Trilogy rookie premiere right there, level one. Quinn Hughes. Quinn Hughes for the Knucks. 270. Larry Resch takes it. 270 out of 999. Larry Resch takes the Quinn Hughes for the mini. Beautiful. Very well done, Larry Resch. That zero slot in the mini. Abramov. That Abramov is going to go to Curtis Robinson. But this Quinn Hughes level one for the Canucks is going to Mr. Larry Resch. All right, folks, that's going to do it for Trilogy for us. Let me get these base cards and everything else under control real quick. To review, Quinn Hughes, Blake Lizotte, McKern Red, Senishin Inscription, Go Bruins, Victor Arvey, and a Fabra. Beautiful Preds cards coming out of that box. I love it. Even though they're not going to us, I love seeing the Preds pull. It's fantastic. All right, give me 10 seconds and we're going to get hot on this box of game used. All right, I'm back with you. Who's having fun? I'm having fun. We got the Trilogy out of the way. Now let's get into the essentially the double of our signature break here. This is going to be good. This is going to be real good. I'm excited to see what these boxes have in them tonight. Let's get a box of game used to open up for y'all right now. Here it is. Thick pack. Empty box. Decoy on the ready. Give me a thumbs up and we'll get it opened. Let me Make sure everybody can hear us loud and clear. Come on, Philly. Come on, Philly. Let's see what this game use has in store for us tonight. This heavy stack of cards.
Two autos or memorabilia per box. Man, we pulled two autos and a memorabilia out of one pack. Yeah, there's a little bit of a tuned up box.
Like to shake the hand of that guy that was working the upper deck QIQC line that day. Find out what other days he was working. See if we can get a five diamond pull, five different diamond card pull coming out of Black Diamond. That'd be sick. All right, first card up for Bad Yorkie. Card breaks tonight for SP. SP game used is going to, I believe that's Sarah Rossino for the Dallas Stars. There's a Pavelski rainbow variant, 98 out of 113. Congratulations, Sarah. There you go. It's your first real hit of the night. Let's hope there's many more to come. Joe Pavelski, little rainbow variant out of SP game use. Congratulations. Very nice. All right, that's a good start for the Stars. Next up, Mark Scheifele for the Jets. Tommy Holmesberger. There's a little blue variant auto. We are pulling some heat so far. Look at that. Mark Scheifele. Fantastic elite player for the Winnipeg Jets. And you just pulled an auto card for him. A little blue variant. Congratulations. There's a beautiful card. Mark Scheifele. Great player for the Jets. No, it's not Seguin. At least not yet, it's not Seguin. Caden Fulcher, authentic rookie. There's a true, I believe that's a true authentic rookie. It's 29 of 36. There's a true authentic rookie, Mr. Aaron Ford. Caden Fulcher, 29 of 36. It's a low, low number for that card. Call that a true authentic rookie, I believe. I believe that's what they're called. Very nice. This is a good box so far. True rookie. Yes, sir. All right. Here comes a thick card. Let's pull it right now. Banner year for the Blackhawks, Dylan Strome. Keaton Parker. There you go. Banner year for the Blackhawks. BWC3 for Dylan Strome for the Blackhawks. Good little pickup right off the bat for the Blackhawks and Mr. Keaton Parker tonight. Gets you in a big old 180. All right, moving on. Kucherov for the Lightning. That goes to the mini as an All-Star Skills jersey fabric card with no serial number. Sarah Rossino picks up another one. Congratulations, Sarah Rossino. I know it's not Tyler Seguin, but it is Nikita Kucherov. He is one of the best players in the NHL. I'm sure you know all about him, but if you double-check, if you want to look at the real statistics for Nikita Kucherov, take a look back at just about any of the past 3 years in the NHL and what the January scoring leader is for every one of those years. I can almost guarantee every year it's been Nikita Kucherov. Usually got a triple digits by about January or February. There you go. Last card out of the first box coming out right now is going to be a Tara Hirose for the Red Wings. Aaron Ford, 173 out of 599 gold foil, white jersey, authentic rookie. Not a bad box to start things off tonight as we shift gears and kind of pick up some speed moving into Black Diamond. Very, very nice. Love it. To review this box, Tara Hirose, Kucherov, Dylan Strome banner year, Caden Fulcher, true authentic rookie, numbered to 36 as jersey number, Mark Scheifele, blue variant auto, veteran card, and a Pavelski to start us off. Great first game use box right there. Let's do it again. Let's do it better. Oh, Kucherov's a magician with a puck. He's magic. Very, very good. Very, very good. I don't feel he gets the credit that he deserves, but you know, it's hard when he's on the ice, you know, against guys like McDavid and Sid and a few others out there, Eichel and all that other stuff. Kucherov's a little more of a veteran, but my goodness, has he got a toolbox to support it. Absolutely beautiful hockey player right there. He's a beauty. True Russian beauty. Kucherov. All right. This pack is a little thinner than the last one, which usually means it is hopped up on autos. Let's find out if that's true. As you can see, it is thin. But that's usually a good thing because they take out some of the more bulky mid-range cards in the 180s. Oh, I would love to see some Nashville Diamonds so I can cry some more about this break. Oh, yes, sir. All right. What do you guys think? All right, let's take a second to talk about it. Well, I know we brought it up. We got a whole bunch of people listening. What do you want for tomorrow? Tomorrow is 9 a.m. Eastern Standard Time break. What do you want? Your options are the 20 boxer SP Game Use and SPX, or the other option is 5 boxes artifacts and a sealed inner of 17-18 Black Diamond. 10 box mixer between those two products. Or if you have another option, just throw it out there in the stream chat. I'll take a look at it afterwards, and I'll throw something together. You tell me. Tell me what you want. All these breaks that I post are all stuff you guys have asked for. I love it. We love supporting you guys in this group, and there we go. Here's what happens when we don't take the preds. Bobro. I wonder whose fingerprint that is. Not mine. Probably one guy from Upper Deck. Hopefully he's not a criminal. But there's a Fabro, 95 to 298 authentic rookie. Just slaying the Predators cards tonight. Just, I don't know, maybe I'll get some sleep tonight, but probably not. Thinking back about this break so far, 3 boxes in, had a significant amount of Preds hits, and we don't have it. You want a 10 box or Black Diamond 1920? I can do that too. We can do that all day long. Yeah, that'd be an easy one. It's going to be pricey. Well, you guys know what the prices are. Just all... Here, I'll give you a hint. I don't jack up the prices on you guys. I'll tell you how this is done. If you want to know what a 10 boxer is going to cost per team, go back and do a search in our group of what the 5 boxer costs, because we've done a couple 5 box sealed inners, just plain Black Diamond, and then just double it, multiply by 2. That's essentially that's the math. All right, yeah, 10 boxer or Black Diamond, that would be sick. I like where your head's at, Ray. That's cool. And you know who's got the most Black Diamond in stock out of anybody in the United States right now? Well, we can definitely support that. Next card coming up right now. How about a Sidney? Oh man, true veteran card on hand. Sid Crosby going to the Penguins. Cody Phil Blom. Beautiful. Look at that number, folks. Out of 87. There's a true veteran for you. That is a. I know it looks like a very, very just basic plain Jane card, but that serial number makes a huge difference in the collectability of this particular card. That is a 42 out of 87. That is what we call a true veteran card. Well done, Cody Phil Blom. That's card number 2. I knew this was going to be a cool box. All right, next up. Pulling some awesome cool little cards out of this. How about a Leon Bergman for the Sharks? Buckle up, folks. Sharks went to the mini. This is a blue variant authentic rookie, and if anybody collects SP Gamers, you know what that means. There's no serial number on it. Sarah Rossino. How about that for the Sharks? Leon Bergman. Sarah Rossino picks up an auto for the Sharks with no serial. Little sapphire, I think, variant on that bad boy. That's going to her. Sean, I'm pretty sure she's ahead. I know you're pulling some Preds, and I know I'm with you on the Preds, but she's either catching up very, very quick or she's right there with you right now. The price is high, $5 Black Diamond and $5 SBA. Yeah, SBA, I don't know. We did a couple masters of SBA earlier, and we did a whole bunch of personals for it on release week. Yeah, I don't know. SBA is kind of, yeah, it just doesn't do it for me. I'm more than happy to carry it for personal breaks, but the breaks took forever to close. Everybody's really just in it for the FWAs, the Future Watch Autos. It's not even a real pretty product. Like, it just isn't well designed, and it's got a whole bunch of random stuff in it. Yeah, I guess you could kind of pull some pretty cool updated Young Guns, but like the allure for those, like they were like the David Ayers and the Shesterkins and all that stuff. The prices were so jacked up through the roof that first week, but now you could go buy David Ayers for $20. I mean, people were paying $100 to $200 right there the first night they were out. And I think that the allure of the SPA this year, I think, is just wearing off. But yeah, the Future Watch Autos are cool. But then again, like when you crack an inner of it, I mean, heck, I got 660 base cards that I pulled out of that I can't do anything with. I mean, we'll give them away. But at the same time, like, you guys are paying a lot of money. I mean, we're paying a you're paying a premium for that product to get a release week. And, you know, 70% of the cards in there are just going to the wayside. When we go back to the stuff that we really enjoy, you know, doing here, a lot of it is the cards are just beautiful and they maintain their value, and it's the hits. If you want to chase the hits, I get it. With SBA, you want to chase the Future Wash autos. And a few other cards are tucked in there, here and there. Some acetate, Young Guns. Yeah, I get it. I understand completely. But as far as the actual product goes, I'd rather just go after the hits. If that's what you guys want, because everybody in this group seems to just want the hits. But I'm open to it. SBA is not something we keep in stock, except for a few for personal boxes. Hey, Corey, what's up? Yeah, the Young Gun acetates pull a premium. That dude's not going to get $700, I can promise you that. But, yeah, we'll figure something out. We'll get around to it. Here we go. New Jersey Devils. Marty Brodeur for the Devils. Philip Nascimento picking up a piece of history. 40 wins club. Numbered 81 out of 99. Philippe Nascimento. Cool. These are kind of a cool little piece of history cards. We pulled a few of these. We pulled a Lemieux. We pulled a Patrick Waugh. There's a few floating out there. They got some value to them. Good little cards. Martin Brodeur. Marty Brodeur. All right, next up out of this one is going to go to Patty Kane for the Blackhawks. Keaton Parker, a little All-Stars skills fabric card. Keaton Parker, there you go, for the Blackhawks. I was kind of on board with the SBA thing, and I don't mean to, I'm not trying to rant or kill anybody's dreams with the SBA, but I had this feeling going into the SBA, especially when we started looking and offering it to the group. I wanted to bring it to this group to obviously stay current and give you guys, because there are some collectors of the SBA stuff in this group. But at the same time, like, I was just so disappointed with how bland of a product it is. I mean, we could sit here and blow this roof off my house, opening up boxes of Black Diamond with the diamond cards and all the brilliance and all that stuff that comes out of it. But when you open up SPA, I just feel like I watched a couple videos of other breaking groups on it, and it was like guys were just shucking the packs as fast as they could to try to get these FWAs. And the same dudes were the same dudes, but before the break was even over, they were snapshotting a picture out of the break stream and putting them up on eBay for a couple $100 trying to get that early money. Like, I get, if you do that, that's cool. But my goodness, I'm in it to collect, and I'm in it to enjoy the hobby. But I'll, you know, we'll open if you want to. I just need a little bit more than, I need some group consensus on. Here we go. How about an Oliver Wahlstrom? 91 out of 599 for the Islanders. Kyle Hoglander. I got a little gold foil white jersey card for Oliver Wahlstrom. A couple of hits for you on that late in the day. Islanders pickup. Very nice. All right. There's our second box of SP Game Used. We're officially halfway done with this break, and we just crested the 46-minute mark. Might be talking a lot again tonight. Apologize for that if you guys were looking to get to bed early. But thanks for tuning in. Wahlstrom, Patty Kane, Martin Brodeur, the Bergman Blue Auto going to Sarah Rossino, Crosby True Veteran card, and a Fabro Rainbow Variant Authentic Rookie. Beautiful. SPX up next. Give me just a second, folks. All right, here we go. Get the decoy set off to the side, and let's get some. Maybe we got a little more room on the table. We can open it back up to normal style here. Get some room for some hits. Let's get in some SPX. Bad Yorkie card breaks tonight, and we have nobody in the fight. We are here for you and you only tonight. Opening up these cards. We are not chasing anything. We missed out on the Oilers. Thank you, Nathan DeGagne. And we missed out on the Preds. Thank you, Sean Heckman. I'm just kidding. We're glad to see those teams go. Supporting the hobby. This is fantastic. First up, SPX. See what we got here. What could it be? We got a little rookie action going on. Let the focus take the card. And behind it, we got a Connor Clifton. Very nice. Kyle Hoglander for the Bruins. Connor Clifton. Let's see if I can get a... That's going to be a thick sleeve needed for that bad boy. It's a rookie base card. Numbered 222 out of 349. It is a thick one. Decoy side. Here's a thick pack. Let's see what this pack has in it. SPX. Could be anything. Let's see what we got. Shadowbox. Who's it going to? Number 90. Ryan O'Reilly for the Blues. Jennifer Lewis. Beautiful card right there. Shadowbox. Veteran. Shadowbox veteran card for Ryan O'Reilly, MVP from last year's Stanley Cup. See what he does this year. It's coming soon. All right, Jennifer Lewis for the Blues. Beautiful. Beautiful. Let's see here. All right. Down here by myself tonight in the dungeon, in the vault. Don't have any help, so I'm trying to pay attention as much as I can to the stream chat. But I also want to get you all your cards. Let's see what we got here. This feels pretty good. Rookie gold action. How about Texier for the Blue Jackets? And who's the serial number holder on this one? 68 goes to Joshua Parker. That's numero 68 out of 399. That is a hit for Mr. Joshua Parker in the mini. Here we go. Nice little pickup. Texier gold rookie jersey card. It's a little heater there. Beautiful. Texier. All right. I'm going to pull that. I'm going to get that. Actually, that's a one hundo. I'm going to get that into a... I'm going to grab some 120s. In fact, I got a 130 right here. Probably will fit nicer into... Yeah, there we go. That's a better fit for that card. A little better presentation. There we go. Go ahead and crack up with some 20s just in case. Got them all sitting here, but they're all shrink wrapped from Ultra Pro to rip off the cellophane. Seems like we go through about a billion of these a week. There we go. There's 120s on standby. All right. Was a mini before I hit Montreal. Yeah, you did. Yeah, you did. All right. Last pack. Oh, this one is heavy. Wonder what could be in here. Wonder what could be in here, folks. Oh, black border. Is this what I think it is? Please tell me it's the break that I don't get into. Somebody's going to pull a sick Pride of a Nation. Actually, no. This is something else. Boom! Blue Jackets. Lustrous rookie on-card auto for Texier. Another Blue Jackets hit. And it goes to the mini. Digit one, Kyle Hoglander. That is a heavy card. I thought for sure that was a Pride of a Nation. No, sir. That is a sick, lustrous rookie premium. Wow. Look at that Columbus Blue Jackets hit. Sorry, I got to open up some more. Got to grab another bag of pennies for super thick, juicy cards. Blow through so many of them on this group. Look at that monster. Alexander Texier, on-card auto, lustrous rookies, and a tri-color. That's part of his number. That is a beautiful card. Outstanding. Kyle Hoglander. And it's number 71 out of 125. A little limited action. Dang, that's a cool card. Still no Philly. Give it a minute. Connor Clifton, Ryan O'Reilly, Texier, and then a better Texier. That's a good box. All right, let's keep it going. Let's roll into the next one hot. Sean says we need to chase some Philly. A little bit of a Philly drought lately. There were a few Phillies that came out last night. They came late. Nothing too crazy, though. But we're on a little bit of a Philly drought. Let's see what we can do about that with this box. And then two boxes of BD coming up right behind it. Ripping and racking them up tonight. That box was meant for Ohio. Yeah, somewhere in Ohio, they've got two flyer cards. No, you're absolutely right. Somebody probably just pulled back-to-back Joel Farabee, Pride of a Nation. They're like, what? What are these junks doing in Ohio? All right, here we go. It's always hard for me to tell which way's up. This is up. We got a Black Obsidian jersey coming. How about for the Lightning? Braden Point. Braden Point. And you know from our earlier breaks, Black Obsidians do not have serial numbers. Going to the mini, Sarah Racino hits another one. Congratulations, Sarah Racino. You now have a Braden Point Game Used Black Obsidian jersey card on the way to you here very soon. That is a hot card right there. I do have to be glad that I grabbed more 120s because this card is going to take all of a 120 and potentially a 130. Beautiful, Sarah Racino. Rock and roll. We'll catch up with the Flyers. If not tonight, you know we will. We pulled some monster Flyer cards so far this year. They're bound to be in here somewhere. All right. Rock and roll. What do we got here? How about a Barrett Hayton for the Coyotes? 120, Larry Resch takes the Barrett Hayton. 120 to 199, limited rookie. Absolutely beautiful card right there. Barrett Hayton, phenomenal rookie this year. And I'll grab another 120 because this is a little bit of a limited card, so it's a little thicker than the normal rookies. Barrett Hayton. All right. What kind of heat could be left in this box? Here we go. All right. Let's see what we got. It's a rookie. It's a 49. It's a Joel Farabee. All right. There you go. So it started. At least I opened up the floodgate for you, bud. That's a gold rookie, orange jersey card, 106 out of 199, Joel Farabee. At least I started getting the floodgate open. That's how it starts right there. Let's get this in a big old thick penny and thrown into a 120. That is a pretty looking card right there with the gold accent, the gold foil. Farabee, gold rookie. There you go. Momentum. Got to start somewhere. Ooh, this is a thick pack. This is a thick pack, folks. Could be anything. Let's see what we got. Oh, here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Oh, this could be good. There's some rookie action. There's some Kirby Doc for the Blackhawks. Keaton Parker. Look at this beaut of a card. Holy smokes, Kirby Doc, premium tricolor patch with an auto to go with it. Limited number, 30 of 35. That is a monster of a card to pull out of a box of SPX. Keaton Parker, congratulations. You are picking up some great hits tonight, buddy. That is a good one and a good one to have right there. Kirby Doc, let's drool over that for a second. Very nice card. Very, very nice card. All right. So we got the Braden Point, Barrett Hayton, Joel Farabee to start the Flyers off tonight. And then this monster of a super thick 180, Kirby Doc, Chicago Blackhawks, 30 of 35. That is a monster card. Put that right there in the back. Folks, you know what's coming next. Give me 30 seconds. I need to refill my drink and I'll be right back. All right, I'm back. All right, that was a sick hit. Sick hit for the Blackhawks. Speaking of black, let's move into Black Diamond. Who's ready? I'm ready. Let's do it. Here it goes. You know what we got in here. Exquisite. right there. I'll set the exquisite off to the side, and then we got that's heavy, man. That's heavy. There's some dimension to that last card in there too. Who knows what that's gonna be? That was a pretty Kirby Doc. All right, let's get the decoy ready and let's get this exquisite pack opened up. So these are some of my favorite cards this year coming out of this exquisite pack. We actually started a little bit of a collection. Hayden and I did, picking up some exquisites here and there, just because I think they're so beautiful. They're such good cards. We picked up, or at least the tricolor patch variants. That's what we've started a little bit, a little tiny collection of. Let's see if we can get one right here. How about a Noah Dobson, 49 of 75 for the Islanders. Kyle Hoglander strikes again. There you go. A little exquisite rookie collection action for. Beautiful picture of Noah Dobson on there. Throw that in a giant 180 right there. And there's your kickoff tonight for Black Diamond. Oh, this is a very... This is all so heavy, but some just feel heavier than others. Let's see what we got here. Let's do it. Let's look. I'm not going to look. Let's peek together, folks. Let's see what we got. Okay. All right. Well, you know what that means. I don't know if it's possible or not, or possible for us to pull more, but holy smokes, we sure are trying hard. Let's take a look. Dear Lord. Okay, we know that at a minimum, that's a premium relic, if not some sort of diamond. Yeah, that's awesome. What would that be? I mean, out of the past four black diamond and a diamond cutter on the bottom. Oh, yeah, there's something there. Yeah. Out of the past five or six black diamond breaks we've done, we pulled at least that many, if not more, diamond cards. I want to say that out of the past six black diamond breaks we've done, we pulled 10 diamond cards. Everything from a single diamond all the way up to the quad diamond Ovi and the quad diamond Jack Hughes we pulled last night. And that's just recently. If you go back a month, we pulled two Jack Hughes quad diamonds out a month ago and also pulled some triples and some other stuff. I think that last one's a diamond cutter, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, if that's an Ellis or an Arvidsson diamond card, you might see the stream chat go dead for about 30 seconds. I'm just kidding. All right, here we go. We got to get through a card or two before we can get to that black card. Let's see what we got. Ooh, there's a Timo Solani. We pulled one of these last night. It was the tricolor premium jersey variant. There's a Timo Solani for the Ducks. There's a Ray Rangel hit. 27 of 99. All right, Ray, you're on the board. Welcome. Talking about being skunked, and this kills the skunk for you. Ray Rangel's on the board. So this next card could be it could be anything from a premium relic up to a black diamond. So let's see what we got. Boom. Abramov, Senators. Curtis Robinson. 73.99. Yes, sirree. We have pulled another diamond card. Unreal this year. The amount of diamond cards we pulled for this group. Just unbelievable. Curtis Robinson for the Ottawa Senators. Vitaly Abramov. Yep, I ripped the band-aid off on that one and get it done. That is a beautiful card right there. Single diamond. Vitaly Abramov. All right. Let's keep the train going. Keep the hits rolling. What do we got next? We've got Claude Giroux. Diamond Mine Relic for the Flyers. I knew we had opened up the floodgate. Here come the Flyers. They seem to be catching up late in the game recently. They're doing it again. Claude Giroux, little white jersey action, diamond mine relic. Beautiful. We know that's going to Sean Heckman. He's got the Flyers on this one. All right, let's see what else we can pull. Two cards left. Nick Suzuki for the Habs. All right, Joshua Parker, Habs are on the board. Little rookie gem, low numbered variant, numbered 93 of 99. The Habs are in play. You know they always show up. Canadians always show up. Waited a little longer than usual tonight, but they always show up. Great value buy for the Habs this year. And then I believe we've got a diamond cutter of some sort, so let's see who it's going to be. Maybe it's not a diamond cutter. Maybe it's a diamond knight. Johnny Gaudreau, diamond knight. Oh, that's kind of pretty. Holy smokes, the whole card, the whole middle of the card is an acetate. I've never even seen one of these. Johnny Gaudreau for the Flames, Aaron Ford. Beautiful card. How hot is that card? The whole middle portion is just like a thick little, almost like a piece of glass. It's an acetate, but it's a real thick acetate. Oh my goodness. 65 of 99. That is a beautiful pull right there for Mr. Aaron Ford for the Calgary Flames. Now that's a very, very interesting box of Black Diamond for our first one. And as usual, I'm going to have to do some manipulation to get this sleeved up later, but I will sleeve it up, I promise you. I'm going to leave it on top of this neoprene mat we have, non-mori mat, right here, because otherwise I'll be sitting here for 5 minutes trying to fight getting that thing over all the sharp edges on that card. That's beautiful. Yeah, put a decoy behind it. Got to grab one out of the decoy pile right here. Yeah, it's got a picture of the rink and everything on it. It's beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Get in the light over there. Very cool. Very, very cool card. All right. So we got the Gaudreau, Diamond Knight, Dobson, Exquisite, Suzuki Rookie Gem, Clojure Diamond Mine Relic, Abramov Single Diamond, another diamond card for this group. I believe that's 11 in like 7 breaks or something. It's crazy. And then the Johnny Gaudreau and the Timo Solani Limited going to Mr. Ray Rangel. I'm going to set this on top back here so I remember right away to get it sleeved up. And we're going to get going on box Black Diamond number 2. Yeah, nice. Nice PC pull right there, buddy. I've never even seen one of those cards. We pulled a lot of the, not a lot, but a few of those diamond cutters and the diamond relic. But that is a, I've never seen the one that has like the rink acetate in it and the whole middle section of that. That's a heavy pack too. Whole middle section of that card is just clear. Beautiful. Beautiful card. I'm glad we can help out your PC tonight. Here comes the Exquisite for Black Diamond box number 2. Last box in this 8-box mixer we got going tonight. Let's see what we got here. Could be anything. Could be anything. And it's going to be Brännström for the Senators. There's another Senators hit. Curtis Robinson again. 287 to 299. Exquisite rookie patch. These are the cards I was talking about. These are the ones that we started collecting. Absolutely beautiful. I love how these cards look, and I love the level of quality in that patch right there with the stitching and everything else. Phenomenal. There's a Brännström. Brännström hit for the Senators. That's 2 very, very solid. I guess I'm out of 180s. Along with 3 180s tonight. Just murdering the 180s tonight. Open up some more. There we go. Sorry about the delay. Got to get these cards protected. It's your investment that we want to take care of. We put them in the sleeves and the one touch, or the top loaders, the one touch right away. All right. Here we go. Pack of Black Diamond coming up right now. Pack of Black Diamond coming up right now. Let's see what this pack has in store for us. Oh, my goodness. Are you kidding me? Is anybody else seeing this? Are you kidding me? Another one? What are the odds? Like, just tell me, somebody's got to be paying attention to the math. Like, what are the odds that we actually pull this many diamond cards out of Black Diamond this year? It's like every single break, whether it's a 2-boxer, a 3-boxer, a 5-boxer, a 10-boxer, a Black Diamond, the 10-boxers were pulling 3 or 4 Black Diamond cards out of them. These ones, even the 1-boxers were pulling Black Diamond, their diamond cards out. Could be, yeah, Premium Relic could be. Actually, I really like those Premium Relic 25s. Tell you the truth, I'd probably rather have one of those in our personal collection. Yeah. I'd rather have a Premium Relic than one of those single or double diamonds. I don't know. Those premium relic cards are just probably the most well-designed card I've seen in a very long time. They really give those twin patch autos for artifacts a run for their money. I just think they're absolutely beautiful. All right, first card up. Here it comes right now for the Panthers. For the Panthers, go to the mini. Evgeny Dadonov, number 58 out of 249, Joshua Parker. Joshua Parker takes that one home. There you go, Joshua Parker. Got a normal card sleeve. Keep it nice and tight. Evgeny Dadonov for the Panthers. Beautiful. All right, second card out of the second box of Black Diamond is coming up right now. And there's a Barrett Hayden. Barrett Hayden. Silver on black, Barrett Hayden, 085 out of 249 to the mini and Mr. Sean Heckman's bank account. Take that one to the bank. Look at that. Beautiful SOB for Mr. Barrett Hayden because the Coyotes run to the mini tonight. There you go, Sean. Now you're catching back up. Getting some steam. I know it's not Flyers, but holy smokes, that's one of the hottest rookies in the game right now. There we go. All right. Thick card coming up next. Let's see what it is. Team Logo Jumbo, Philip Zadina. Beautiful. Who's got the red? Aaron Ford has the Red Wings tonight. There's a TLJ for you. There's a couple people in the group that are chasing these very, very hard. One of our guys, new member, came and joined the group specifically just looking for those, I believe. Joined a break last night. Thought he was done and out of the break, moving in the very last box, and then pulled the Zadina TLJ he was looking for. Outstanding. Very, very nice. Red Wings. All right, here comes that black border card coming up next. What could it possibly be? Are you... Stop. Seriously, another Preds hit? Man, and it's a premium relic for Ryan Ellis. Aw, jeez. Aw, jeez. 46 out of 50. That is a beautiful card. I am very happy for you. Very happy for you. No, congratulations. That is a beautiful card. Of all the premium relics to pull with the Preds colors on, I'm glad to see it. I'm glad that you were able to pull that in our breaking group. That is a beautiful, beautiful card right there. I'm not sure if you actually collect the Predators or not, but you know who does. We do, and you got a lot of Preds moving towards your address here very, very soon. We got one card left and one card left out of Black Diamond. Who could it be, and who could it be? Too bad it's only out of 50, yeah. All right, here we go. Oh, let's see what we got. What do we got? What do we got? The Rangers. Hey, there's a Wayne Gretzky, 31 and 99. So that's out of 99. Is that considered a true veteran? Somebody's got to make that determination. All right. Cody Feldblom, 31 and 99. You got a Gretzky, a little throwback. 31 and 99 for the Rangers. Kind of nice right there. And like I said, it's a 31 out of 99. Gretzky's jersey number is 99. I mean, is that like I said, that might still be a kind of a stretch, but potentially a true veteran? I don't know. What do you guys think? Interesting topic of conversation. Wayne Gretzky, beautiful. Brännström, exquisite rookie. Zadina, TLJ. Barrett Hayden, SOB. Dadonov. Little base variant, and this monsterly beautiful. Nobody else in the group probably likes this card, but I am in love with the way these cards are designed. These premium relics, I love it. 46 out of 50. Congratulations! I'd like to thank all of you for staying with us tonight. Pay attention here shortly. I'll post a teaser post for our break going live at 9 a.m. Eastern Standard Time tomorrow morning. Haven't decided, but I'm about 90% sure we're going to be posting what we were talking about earlier. Pay attention tonight if you want to see that teaser post. Otherwise, set your alarms. 9 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, 5 a.m. Alaska time for the rest of us. We'll see you tomorrow. Thanks, guys.